I definitely wanted to talk about this part during the first half. Yubaba is so misconceived by the regular audience, which just disappoints me, because audience basically understands things through lines. That's how they distinguish good and bad people. To them, Yubaba is bad and cruel, while Zeniba, who Chihiro gets on the train to go meet, good. That happens because the audience only pays attention to what the characters say. I mean, for example, Chihiro hugs her and says, "Thank you, Grandma," so the audience gets tricked. But no way! Zeniba is 100 times scarier than Yubaba, which I'll talk more on next week. Yubaba is a witch, which makes her originally a human. Well, she has a huge face and also transforms into a bird, but those are her magics. She has many subordinates like frogs and slug-looking women working for her at a bathhouse called Abraya. But some say this place is actually a good standing company, as there's a popular tweet on Twitter. She's a witch with a great talent for management who gives a chance to anyone motivated to work, treats newcomers equally, praises good performances, and repels unreasonable guests by herself. And by the way, about her repelling unreasonable guests, it says Dragon Ball on the storyboard for the scene where Yubaba shoots Kamehameha at No Face. You see how the creators are being playful in Spirited Away. There are actually many scenes with this kind of jokes, especially associated with Yubaba because her Kamehameha attack doesn't work on Note Face, and instead, he sprinkles mud on her and gets her covered by mud from head to toe, but the audience doesn't really find it funny because she's depicted as a horrific figure, so people don't see her as a funny person. Isao Takahata, another Ghibli director, was being sarcastic about this. He said, "This movie has more movements compared to the Castle of Cagliostro, but no one laughed." But there are many jokes. I personally think a line like "the nonsense has got to stop" is it's a good line. Another Twitter post says, "Abraya provides a great working environment for sleeping workers as they are supplied with the uniforms, spare clothes, and meals. They just flip wooden tags instead of punching time cards, so they are flexible. They can easily take days off with good reasons and do things like temporarily sneaking out of work without getting scolded, as long as they follow the basic rules. So it's good standing company." What's funny is that, although it was later omitted, when Kamaji and Chihiro purged the spell, there was a long conversation. Kamaji says, "That stamp is horrifying. That stamp makes people become slaves of witches." But when Chihiro says, "I thought everyone was working as slaves and I've become one of them," Kamaji says, "Huh, we are authentic laborers. We chose to work here. It's our freedom to stay or leave because we've kept our name secret to the witch." So they work by contract. I mean, it's a real shame that this conversation got omitted, because it indicates that Yubaba does not dominate the employees but hire them. This shows how much self-esteem she has about herself. She does all these to protect her idealized self-image. Even so, she has some shortcomings. That is, she just loves people too much. That's her problem. She has too much sympathy towards the ones she loves to the point that she can't let them go. For example, she dotes on that gigantic baby called Bo. Well, that's kind of obvious. But even ones like Haku and Chihiro, Yubaba actually likes them more than we think. She says some nasty things to them, but she also acknowledges them. For example, Chihiro goes to see Zeniba and apologizes to her. But when Yubaba finds that out, she becomes furious and says, "What?" And then goes, "Kill her parents, kill and eat those pigs. But that's basically because she has too much love towards her. Once she likes them, she can't let them leave her. If they do, she can't accept it. Meanwhile, she says Haku is useless. Once he's injured and tells her subordinates to throw him away, but there's a reason for that. She actually loves whoever is capable and beneficial for her, but once they are no longer useful or they leave her, she suddenly hates them extremely or tries to get rid of them. That's what kind of person she is. She's actually too human. She's not beautiful for sure, but she's lovable. Well, then where do those employees originally come from? Like those ladies looking like frogs. There are different contradictory settings about this movie. For example, one setting says that frogs or slugs turn into humans, while another one says the other way around. That's because Miyazaki told different settings every time he spoke to the animators. So there's no one officially consistent setting. One thing to note is that Yubaba employs frogs and slugs. They originally had the same name in Japan back in the days. There's a field of study in natural history in ancient Japan called Honsogaku, or herbalism. It's spelled Hon, meaning real, and So, meaning grass, and Gaku, which means to learn. In this field, creatures are categorized into humans, beasts, birds, and fish. But all living things except humans, beasts, birds, and fish are considered bugs. So, for example, snakes are considered bugs. Because of that, there is a type of snakes called mamushi that has a word mushi or insect in its name. So any small-sized animals are categorized as bugs, such as lizards or spiders. So Yubaba is a person who loves bugs. She's like a princess who loves bugs. In one word, that's Nausicaa. Yubaba is a person like Nausicaa, but not only that, she treats her colleagues equally and respects contracts, which also makes her Lady Eboshi. So Yubaba is a tyrant version of Eboshi from Princess Mononoke. She was originally like Nausicaa, but as she grew, she had to start making rules for the community and keep them. It worked while everyone was equal, or while she was still young. But as she got older, some sort of passion, which she managed to control when she was younger, went out of control, which turned her into a tyrant. That's why I say Yubaba is the tyrant version of Eboshi. I'm guessing that Yubaba was once more intelligent and humane, but now she got obsessed with the people or treasures she fell in love with, then eventually lost humanity that she used to have, then started being hated or feared. Or you can say that she's the future of Dola from Castle in the Sky. But above all, Yubaba is probably the reflection of how Miyazaki sees Toshio Suzuki, the Ghibli producer. Or maybe she's Miyazaki himself, because they're both famous for patronizing their staff they like, but acting cold to those who leave them. Now, let's finish up the mystery of Yubaba. She's the final stage of the heroines of Ghibli anime. Miyazaki usually portrays his heroines as good girls like Shita when they are young, but they eventually start having inner passions like Nausicaa, then becomes a good leader like Eboshi, then a greedy woman like Dola, then finally ends up becoming a tyrant like Yubaba, who can't control her own desires and love towards her people. These are the images of the heroines in Miyazaki's films, and they're connected in a cycle. We think if they're young, then they stay young eternally. For example, Shita is always the same Shita, and Clarice is always the same Clarice. But in Miyazaki's minds, his characters always grow. That's why they age. That's how Miyazaki often says that in Princess Mononoke, no, I mean My Neighbor Totoro, Satsuki and Mei are already over 30 years old. So they're old ladies now. But it's interesting to know how the characters evolve like this. Yubabae has a strong sense of justice and takes good care of her people. When she goes to extreme though, she starts loving them or relying on them too much, then she ends up being skeptical about them. Then she feels lonely, then eventually turns into a tyrant. So that's the evolution theory of heroines to Miyazaki.